एल जी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अ सब्जेक्ट दैट इज कंट्रोल सिस्टम डिजाइन एंड इन दिस सब्जेक्ट वी विल डिस्कस द एग्जांपल ऑफ लैग कंपनसेटर यूजिंग द लूप ब्रोकर्स. In our previous video, we just discussed one example that is same related to lag compensator. Today also we will discuss the example of lag compensator using the root locus. So let's start our today's session. See here, the question is what? It's an open loop system, G of S that equal to K upon S, S plus 1, S plus 4. Now design a suitable compensator for the damping ratio that equal to 0.5, omega n that is 0.8 radian per second, and here see kV is given to us. In our previous video, if you remember, then ESS will given to us. From the ESS, we are just finding the value of kV, that is 1 upon ESS. But here directly the value of kV that is given to us. So what is the first step? We have to draw the uncompensated root locus. So for that, we are just finding the poles and zeros. So my poles are at 0, minus 1, minus 4. And 0, that is 0. Now next, centroid. The equation is what? It's a summation of real part of poles minus summation of real part of zeros divided by n minus m. Now the pole that is at 0, minus 1 and minus 4 divided by 3 minus 0. So if we solve this, then our sigma c that is minus 1.67. Now angle of asymptote, and the equation is what? It's a theta k that equal to 2k plus 1 into 180 degree divided by n minus m, and the value of k that will vary from n minus m minus 1. Now the value of n that equal to 3. M is 0. So 3 minus 0 minus 1 that equal to 2. So we will start from 0 and we will add till 2. So 0, 1 and 2. So we will get total 3 angles. And we know that here we have a 3 pole, but we do not have any 0. That's why we are getting what? It's a 3 angle. So first you put k equal to 0. Then the theta 0 that equal to what? It's a 60 degree. Now 1. Then theta 1 that equal to what? It's a 180 degree. And then theta 2 that equal to what? It's a 300. Okay. Now next, breakaway point. For that the equation is what? It's a dk by ds that equal to 0. Now for that, what we require? We require the characteristic equation. And that is 1 plus g of s into h of s that equal to 0. Now you just substitute the value of g of s and h of s that equal to 1 because it is for the unity feedback control system. Now take the LCM. Now you just find out the k that is minus s and you open the bracket. S plus 1, s plus 4. So you will get s square plus 5s plus 4. Now you just multiply this s. Now find out the dk by ds. So differentiation of the s cube is 3s square. Differentiation of 5s square that is 10s. And the differentiation of 4s that is equal to 4. So now you just equate 3s square plus 10s plus 4 that equal to 0. So here we will just use this equation to find out the roots of this equation. So s that equal to minus d plus or minus b square minus 4ac upon 2a. So the value of a, that is coefficient of s square, b is what? It's a coefficient of s, and c is what? It's a constant. Now you just substitute this value in our equation. So s equal to minus 10 plus or minus under root of 100 minus 48 divided by 6. You solve this. Then what do you get? S equal to minus 2.86 and minus 0.46. This is what is a breakaway point. Now next step is what? Is an intersection point with the j omega axis. Now here you have the angle of asymptote, that is at 60, 180 and 300. and 60 is what? So less than 90. That's why we are finding this step, that is the intersection point with the g omega axis. Now again, for that we require the characteristic equation, and we will solve this, then we will get this. Okay, now you can find out, you have to find out the step, we have to root alone. So like this, first of all as q, then you just write down the coefficient of the odd power of s. That's why in our first row, you just see, first of all coefficient of the s q, then s square is even power, that we will write in the second row. Fine, in the first row odd power, s is to 1, so 4, and then q. Now for in a s is to 1 row, you just multiply 5 with the 4, that is 20, minus k, cross multiplication, and divide it by what? It's a 5. Then we do not have here any another column, so consider that as a 0. So 5 into 0 minus this into 0 into 1, so that is obviously 0. Now in s is to 0, 20 minus 3 divided by 5, multiply by 5, minus 0, divided by 20 minus k divided by 5. So what do you get? You will get value of k like this. Now what we will do? We have to make one row that equal to 0. Now is it, you have to start from the top row. Is it possible to make s cube row that is 0? The answer is no, because it's a constant 1 and 4. Now is it possible to make s square row that equal to 0? Again answer is no, because the phi is constant. If I put k equal to 0, then after that row is what? Phi and 0. Now s is to 1. Yes, that is possible. If I set k equal to 20, then this 2 will become 0 and 0. So what do you have to take? That is 20 minus k divided by phi that equal to 0. So the value of k that equal to 20. Now from the above row, we have to write down the auxiliary equation, and that is at pi s square plus k that equal to 0. Now you just substitute the value of k that equal to 20. So s square that equal to minus 20 by pi. So s equal to what? That is 4g square. Okay, so s equal to what? It's a plus or minus 2g. Okay, so this is the intersection point with the imaginary axis. Now no need to find out what? That is angle of departure, because we do not have any complex pole in our transfer function. Now this is all our finding, okay, for the uncompensated root locus. Now we will draw this on a root locus graph paper. So that is real and imaginary axis. Now pole are at 0, minus 1 and minus 4. Now you just start with the how much part of the real axis that is lying on my root locus. So from 0 to minus 1, and after minus 1 there are the two poles on the left hand side, okay, on the right hand side. So that is what is the event. So we will not consider that part till minus 4. After minus 4 you just check this side. So the number of poles that equal to 3, so that is an odd number. So till minus 4 to infinity, that part is on my root locus. Now you just mark this 1.67 centroid and draw the three angles. One is 60, then 180, that is what this line, no need to draw it, then 300. Now you just break away point. Now we have a two breakaway point. One is at minus 2.86, another is at minus 0.46. But minus 2.86, that is not on my dark line or highlighted line. So that breakaway point is not valid breakaway point. Only the valid breakaway point is what? It's a minus 0.46. Now, so this root locus, that is start with the 0, it will cut minus 0.46 and it goes to up direction or in a down direction. And for minus 4, we already have a direction, that is 180 degrees. So no need to worry about the minus 4. Only the that is on between 0 to minus 1, start with the zero, it will cut this 0.46 breakaway point, it goes on the direction of 60 or 300. Similarly for this point, it cut the minus 0.46, it goes toward the 60 or you can say 300. So this is what is an uncompensated root locus. Now the next step is what? That is SD. That is desired location of closed loop pole. Okay? So for that, the equation is what? Is SD that equal to zeta omega n plus or minus under root of 1 minus zeta square omega n, where zeta that equal to 0.45 and omega that equal to what? It's a 0.8 radian per second. Now you just substitute this value in our equation. So we will get this. Now if you solve this, then the value of SD that equal to minus 0.4 plus or minus 0.7 J. Now you have to mark this point on our graph paper. So that is somewhere over here. And this is here. And from this graph, we can clearly say that the SD is on my uncompensated root locus. So the procedure that I need to follow, that is for the lag compensator. So from the uncompensated root locus is passed from the SD, therefore the transient response is specified. That's why we have to use the lag compensator with phi p that is almost equal to 0. If you are finding the phi p is what? If you remember, then we are finding the phi p in a lead compensator. In this question, if we are going to find the phi p, then definitely your answer is very near to the 0, or we can say it's a 0. So from that also you can specify whether it is a lead or lag. But no need to confirm the unnecessary step. You just see that whether the SD is on your uncompensated root locus. If answer is yes, then it's a lag compensator. If your answer is no, then it's a lead compensator. Right? Now next step, what we are finding? We are finding that is the gain of the uncompensated system. And every time when we are talking about the gain, we have to take the vector. Remember this one. So the KUCSD that equal to product of vector length from pole to SD divided by the product of vector length from 0 to SD. Now here, you have to draw a one line from SD to 0, SD to minus 1 and SD to minus 4. Like this. And here this distance is what? This is 0.8. Now another, you just draw the line that is SD to minus 1. That is 0.9. Then SD to minus 4, that is 3.7. This distance you have to measure with this K. So here my KUCSD that equal to 2.6. Now we know that the error constant for the type 1 system, that is KV that equal to S tends to 0, S into G of S. Substitute the value of G of S and S equal to 0. And your K is what? It's an uncompensated system gain. So when we solve this, we will get the KV that equal to what? It's 0.65. Now, next we need to find out the beta. So equation is what is the KV required divided by KVUCSD. We have the value of KV required. It is already given in a question. That is 5. And KVUCSD, just we have found out. That is 0.65. So the beta is 7.7, and we know that you will take the higher value. Right now my beta is what? It's between 6 to 10, 6 to 9. So when I take the value beta that equal to what? 10. You can see you can take 8, 9, that is all right. Just you need to take the value of beta that is higher than what you are taking. Now next, that is pi z. See, I am just fixed that pi z, every time you just take pi z that equal to 60. That is all. Obviously you have to take less than 10 degree. But if you take 3 degree, 4 degree, then that line is very near to the origin. And difficult to mark that line. So better you just take pi z that equal to 6 degree. Now first of all you just make a one zeta line, a line that connects the origin and SD. That line is known as a zeta line. Now you have to put your protector on a zeta line, and the center is what is SD, and draw this line that is of 6 degrees like this, and this is what it's your pi bed is less than 6, and the value see it's very near to the origin, that is -0.1. And PC that equal to what? It's a ZC divided by beta. So -0.1 divided by 5, that equal to 0.01. Okay? Now, step number 7, you just put the 0 and 4. That is 0 at 0.1 and 4 is at 0.01. You just multiply the G of F and the compensated system transfer function, that is GC of F. Now we know that in this, the compensated system gain and uncompensated system gain, that is very similar to each other. Why? Because the pole is 0. The 0.1 and 0.01, the distance when you are going to measure that distance, that is almost equal. Right? So here, this is almost that is equal to uncompensated system gain 2.6. So when we substitute 2.6, this is our equation. Now you just find out the KV, that is the compensated system velocity constant at the point of SD. So S tends to 0, S into G of S, GC of S. So it's a 2.6 multiplied by 0.1 upon 1, 4 and 0.01. When we solve this, then we will get it's a 6.5. And this is what is a compensated system velocity constant is higher than what it's a KV required. That is at what it's a 5. So now I hope this is clear. So now till this point we just discuss the example of root locus, that is to design the lead compensator, and that is used to design the lag compensator. So I hope this whole technique is clear. Now onwards, next video session, we will discuss how we can design the lead or lag compensator using the Bode flow, that is the frequency response technique. Okay? Thank you.